Hello students, welcome you all in economics class. In our previous session, we have studied about the concept of poverty and the various measures of poverty. Okay? In this session, we will study about poverty line and poverty line determination. Okay? So, what is poverty line? Usually, we can say poverty line is a line which divides people as poor and non-poor. Okay? In India, poverty line is estimated by Niti Aayog, which is earlier known as Planning Commission. Okay? On the basis of data provided by NSSO. So now, let's see what is poverty line. Poverty line refers to that line which expresses per capita average monthly expenditure that is essentially required by the people to satisfy their minimum needs or minimum requirements necessities. Okay. Or you can also say that poverty line refers to the cutoff point that divides people of a region as poor and non-poor. Okay, you can also say that poverty line refers to the cutoff point that divide people of a region as poor and non-poor. What do you mean by cutoff point? For example, if we are assuming that 1000 rupees we are taking as a monthly consumption expenditure for a person as a cutoff point, if the person is not able to secure 1000 rupees per month as their monthly consumption expenditure will be considered as below poverty line. And the person who are able to secure more than 1000 rupees, they will be considered as non-poor. Okay? The percentage of population who are living below poverty line is known as headcount ratio. Okay? The percentage of population who are living below poverty line is known as headcount ratio. In India, according to 2011 and 12, there are 21.9% people are belonging to below poverty line. The data is also varies on the basis of rural area and urban area. In rural area, 25.9% people are belongs to below poverty line, and in urban area, 13.9% people are belonging to below poverty line. Hope you are able to understand what is poverty line, what is the cutoff point, and what is headcount ratio. Now next, move on. Poverty line determination. Okay? Let me erase it first. So now let's see poverty line determination. There are two determinations of poverty line. First one is minimum consumption expenditure. Second one, minimum calories consumption. So there are two determination of poverty line. One is minimum consumption expenditure and second one is minimum calories consumption. Okay, here we are taking consumption expenditure. We are not taking income as a determination of poverty line. Why we are not considering income? Why we are considering consumption expenditure? Because income shows only the purchasing power or capacity of purchasing. But consumption expenditure actually shows where we are spending our amount on the goods and services. That is why we are considering minimum consumption expenditure as a determination of poverty level. Okay. Now let's see. In India, 972 rupees required for a person in rural area as a monthly consumption expenditure. 972 rupees for a person of rural area. The minimum expenditure of a person, 972 rupees, is decided for rural area, and for urban area it is 1407 rupees per person. For rural area, monthly consumption expenditure required 972 rupees for rural area, and for urban area it is required 1407 rupees. It can be also estimated on the daily basis also, such as 32 rupees per day per person and 47 rupees per day for a person required as a minimum consumption expenditure in urban area. If a person is unable to meet their minimum consumption expenditure, 972 rupees in rural area is belong to below poverty line, and if a person is not able to meet 1407 rupees in urban area, they will be belong to below poverty line. Okay. Previous, it was 816 rupees per person for rural area, and for urban area it has been 1000 rupees per person. Okay. Now it has been revised by 1800 to 972 rupees per person for rural area minimum consumption expenditure, and for urban area it has been decided 1407 rupees per person for their monthly minimum consumption expenditure. Okay. On the per day basis, we can also calculate is 32 rupees per person for their minimum consumption expenditure per day. Okay. And for urban area it is 47 rupees per person per day their minimum consumption expenditure. Okay. Minimum consumption expenditure globally decided by the World Bank also, it is $1.90 per person per day. If a person is not able to need $1.90 per day, it belongs to below poverty line according to World Bank. Now next, move on minimum calorie consumption. Okay, in rural area it has been decided 2435 per person calorie required in rural area, okay, and 2045 per person for urban area. If in rural area a person is not able to attain 2435 calorie in rural area, he or she will belong to below poverty line. And in urban area, if a person is not able to meet 2045 calorie, then he or she belongs to poverty line, below poverty line. Okay. So in the rural area, if a person is not able to meet 2435 calorie, then he or she will be belongs to below poverty line. And for urban area, it has been 2045. Why there is difference between the urban area and rural area? Because in rural area, maximum people are engaged in field activity. They are doing physical activity more than urban area. In comparison to more than urban area people, they are doing physical activity more. Such as they are doing agriculture work, they are the casual laborers. So the calorie required more for the person who are belonging to rural area. Okay. So these are the determination of poverty line, minimum consumption expenditure and minimum calories consumption. Hope you all are able to understand poverty line, and poverty line determination. If you have any question or any doubt, you can send your message. We will solve it in our next session. Okay? Thank you.